So what are the types of existing markup language? Of the different types of existing markup language, Google recommends using the so-called JSON-LD, although we will list others for informational purposes. So the first one is JSON-LD here. If you are at schema.org, just click on that. You can see this is an example of a code. So this JavaScript annotation built into a script tag in the header of a body or of a page. It has two characteristics. It is not interspersed with the text visible to the user, and Google can read it when they're dynamically injected into the context of the page through JavaScript essentially. So this is a script. You can see it here, starting from here, the type to the end here. So this is an example of the JSON-LD. I'll show you how to implement this so you can easily use this one and change and maybe add it to your site. So the next type we're going to look at here is the microdata. So the microdata, you just click on this. Here's how it looks like. So it is an open community for HTML specification that is used to nest structured data within HTML content. That is, it is used as attributes of HTML tags. So you can see how it looks like here. You can see the tags. So this is easily implemented in an HTML website. You can use it if you like. Then the last one we're going to look at is RDFA, which is just an HTML5 extension compatible with linked data by entering HTML tag attributes that correspond to user visible content. So this one is very similar again to the microdata. You can insert it in your HTML site, but Google recommends JSON-LD. JSON-LD is the most important one that we're gonna use. And even in this course, I'll be using JSON-LD in all the examples I'm gonna show you. So this is the one you should get used to it, because Google easily reads it and implements it. But if you want to use the RDFA or the microdata, it's still okay. They'll be able to read them. But for this case, I'll be using JSON-LD. So what kind of content can you mark up? You can mark up almost everything that you have on your website. Like, for example, organizations. You can tell them what kind of organization you are. Are you a marketing agency? What type are you? The business type. Are you a local business? Because this is very important for local listing. Products. Are you selling products on your websites? So you can mark up the products and make them appear having very looking very nice on your on search engines. Offers. Do you have offers that you want to give people that people should know of? Coupons. That is very important. Then you can do people. Are you an important person? Do you want people to know you? Like, example, the Rihanna one which had given you. Events. Are you hosting events that is coming very soon that you want people to be able to learn about it early enough? We can mark up that. News is something new coming up. You can mark up that. If you have a news site, it's very important to mark up that. Creative works like blogs, books, recipes, movies. You can mark all those up. Do you want reviews and ratings on your pages? You can mark that one up. Frequently asked questions. Do you want frequently asked questions on your website? You can mark up that. Or how-tos. Do you do how-tos? Do you want to show people how to do this, how to do that? You can mark up that. So the list is endless. Just go to the site schema.org and you'll be able to see what can be marked up. Just go to home and they will show you what kind of schemas that they allow on their site. Here, a lot of things that can be marked up here. You don't have to choose. Yeah, if you're not sure, just come here and see which type is there. Image object, video object, audio object. There's so many types of examples and extensions that you can use in this case.